This is from Nova Express. I was traveling with the Intolerable Kid on the Nova Lark. We were on the Nod after a rumble in the Crab Galaxy involving this two-way time stock. When you come to the end of a biologic film, just run it back and start over. Nobody knows the difference, like nobody was there before the film. So they start to run it back, and the projector blew up, and we lammed out of there on the blast. Holed up in those cool blue mountains, the liquid air in our spines, listening to a little hi-fi junk note. Pictures you right to metal, and you nod out 1,000 years. Just sitting there in a slate house, wrapped in orange flesh robes, the blue mist drifting around us when we get the call. As soon as I set foot on podunk Earth, I could smell it, that burnt metal reek of Nova. I already set off the charge, I said to the kid. This is a burning planet. Any minute now, the whole fucking shithouse goes up. The Intolerable Kid sniffs and says, yeah, when it happens fast. This is a rush job. And you could feel it there under your feet, the whole structure buckling like a bulkhead about to blow. So we are driving in from the airport, the kid at the wheel and his foot on the floor, and nearly ran down a covey of pedestrians, and they yell after us, what do you want to do, kill somebody? The kid sticks his head out and says, it would be a pleasure. Terrestrial dogs. His eyes light up like a blowtorch, and I can see he's really in form. Now we start right to work, making our headquarters in the land of the free, where the call came from, and which is really free and wide open for any life form, the uglier the better. Well, they don't come any uglier than the Intolerable Kid and your reporter. When the planet is all primed to go up, they call in the kid to jump around from one faction to the other, agitating and insulting all parties, until they all say, by God, before I give an inch, the whole fucking shithouse goes up in chunks. We had to plan what they call the board books to show us what is what on this dead whistle stop. Three life forms uneasily parasitic on a fourth form that is beginning to wise up. And the whole planet is absolutely flapping, hysterical with panic, the way we like to see them. It's a dead easy pitch, the kid says. Yeah, I say, a little bit too easy. Something here, kid, something wrong. I can feel it. The kid can't hear me. We need a peg to hang it on, the kid said. Something really ugly like virus. Not for nothing do they come from a land without mirrors. So he takes over this news magazine. Now, he said, I'll by God show them how ugly the ugly American can be. And he breaks out all the ugliest pictures in the image bank and puts it out on the subliminal. So one crisis piles up after the other right on schedule. And the kid is whizzing around like a buzzsaw. And that black Nova laugh of his, you can hear it now down all the streets. Shaking the buildings, the skyline like stage props. But me, I'm looking around, the more I look, the less I like what I see. For one thing, the Nova heat is moving in fast and heavy like I never see it anywhere else. Kid just thinks I have the copper jitters. So what, he said. I've still got the board books. I can split this whistle stop wide open tomorrow. No use talking to him. I look around some more and find out the blockade on planet Earth is broken. Explorers moving in whole armies. And everybody concerned is fed up with the Intolerable Kid. And all he can say is, so what, I've still got cut. Board books taken. The film reeks of burning switch like a blowtorch. Pre-recorded heat glare massing Hiroshima. This whistle stop wide open to hot crab people. And the Intolerable Kid's errand boys and strike breakers are copping out right, left, and center. Mr. Martin and you board members, vulgar, stupid Americans, you will regret calling in the Mayan Aztec gods with your synthetic mushrooms. Remember, we keep exact junk measure of the pain inflicted, and that pain must be paid in full. Is that clear enough, Mr. Intolerable Martin, or shall I make it even clearer? Allow me to introduce myself. The Mayan god of pain and fear from the white-hot plains of Venice. which does not mean a god of vulgarity, cowardice, ugliness, and stupidity. There's a cool spot on the surface of Venice, 300 degrees cooler than the surrounding area. I have held that spot against all contestants for 500,000 years. Now you expect to use me as your errand boy and strike maker, sum it up by an IBM machine and a handful of virus crystals. How long could you hold that spot, you board members? About 30 seconds, I think, with all your guard dogs. And you thought to channel my energies for your operation total disposal? Your operations there are here, this or that, come and go and are no more. Give my name back. That name must be paid for, and you have not paid. My name is not yours to use. Henceforth, I think, about 30 seconds is written. And you can see the marks are wising up, standing around in sullen groups, and that mutter gets louder and louder. Any minute now, 50 million adolescents will hit the street with switchblades, bicycle chains, and cobblestones. Rock and roll adolescent hoodlums storm the streets of all nations. They rush into the Louvre and throw acid in the Mona Lisa's face. They open zoos, insane asylums, prisons, burst water mains with air hammers, chop the floor out of passenger plane lavatories, shoot out lighthouses, file elevator cables to one thin wire, turn sewers into the water supply, throw sharks and stingrays, electric eels and kangaroo into swimming pools. In nautical costumes, they ram the Queen Mary full speed into New York Harbor, play chicken with passenger planes and buses, rush into hospitals in white coats, carrying saws and axes and scalpels 3 feet long. They throw paralytics out of iron lungs and mimic their suffocations, flopping around on the floor and rolling their eyes up. Administer injections with bicycle pumps. Disconnect artificial kidneys. Saw a woman in half with a two-man surgical saw. They drive herds of squealing pigs into the commodity exchange. They shit on the floor of the United Nations and wipe their asses with treaties, pacts, alliances. By playing car, horse, camel, elephant, tractor, bicycle, steamroller, on foot, ski, sled, crutch, and pogo stick, the tourists storm the frontiers, demanding with inflexible authority asylum from the unspeakable conditions obtaining in Freeland. Chamber of Commerce striving in vain to stem the debacle. Please to be restful. It is only a few crazies who have from the crazy place outbroken. Thank you.